in New World, same as your storages, all markets are local. And to buy or sell items at each marketplace, you will have to physically travel there. This is good for economy, as different territories have different amount of different tier resources available. And not everyone is willing to travel long distance to the most active market to sell what they've just harvested or mined, but will keep their activities within same territory and sell at local marketplace cheaper than on other marketplaces. Plus, with limited storage space, many players will want to get rid of their resources quickly to keep farming more. That opens opportunity for other players who now can buy cheaper at those distant markets, be it for themselves or with the intention of reselling. If you can't find marketplace, just zoom into your map and you will see marketplace icon. At every marketplace, players can use search or powerful filters to find what they are looking for, if they need anything specific, and can browse contents of any market from any settlement. But to buy or sell anything, players will have to travel and visit that particular settlement. Players can place buy or sell orders. In total, we can have up to 50 active orders at any given time. That includes all settlements. This and the fact that each transaction comes with quite harsh taxes and fees should ensure that there will be very little junk available. And please, make sure that you check what price you set before you click place order button, as listing fee will be taken off your balance immediately, and few extra zeros will mean that you lose tens of thousands of coins instead of few hundred. Did that myself. Buy orders apart from listing fees will also require payment upfront. Players can list their items for different amount of time, lowest being 1 day. Increasing listing time increases listing fee, but not linearly. It's cheaper to place 1 3-day order than 3 1-day orders. However, don't place 30-day orders that most likely won't sell, as it's pure waste of your gold, unless you have no space in your local storage. And yes, markets can act like a paid storage. If you want to cancel your order, then make sure that your storage has at least some space available, because if your storage is full, then you won't be able to cancel your order. There has to be at least a little free space available. Same time, if your sell order's time has finished, all remaining items will be stored at your local storage, no matter if there is free space or not, thus going over the space limit and preventing you from depositing there anything until you cleared some space. Also, because we only have a total of 50 orders, using markets as storages might not be good if you are actively trading on markets. I found out myself cancelling a lot of my storage orders just to create a new, bigger ones. And this works until you start storaging high tier resources, which are quite expensive. While you can afford this, it's not such of a big deal. But storing higher tier items like that will drain your wallet quickly. So better make sure that you increase your storage space through standing rewards or by buying a house and placing the 3 highest tier chests that you can afford. Also, use nearby settlement storage sheds, especially for items that you don't use frequently. Normally, I would advise to use one settlement for cooking food, one for crafting armor and weapons, and even more if you want to make jewelry and so on. Fees and taxes are set by owning company's governor, and can be very high or very low, depending on their intentions to earn more money or to turn this local market into a central trading hub. You can reduce trading tax rate through standing rewards too, so if you plan on trading a lot at any particular settlement, spend some time in that territory killing mobs or doing other activities, including crafting, and choose trading tax bonus card when it's offered. Consider investing into crafting fee bonus cards in your main crafting settlement too. Just remember, everything is subject to change, and if you like this video, you know what to do. Also, link to my Discord is down below. Feel free to jump in and say hi, or ask me any questions. That's it for now. Eternum awaits.